Well, good evening, New Life Community Church family. It is great to be gathered together once again. Yes, we're online. And, you know, it's very interesting, isn't it? This kind of time between Christmas and New Year reminds me very much of the time between Good Friday and Resurrection Sunday. There is the time of silence. There's the time of rest. There's the time of indecision sometimes. There's the time of feeling lonely, maybe feeling discarded, maybe feeling that we're not quite sure what is going to be the outcome tomorrow. Especially at Christmas time, right now we're in between the transition of going from wanting no turkey and probably maybe even wanting no food to all of a sudden wanting Chinese, or maybe we just want to fast a few days before we end up eating a wonderful load of food on New Year's Day. It's a great privilege and an honour once again to be able to open up the Word of God this evening. And we've got Pastor Mic Crawley. Pastor Mic Crawley is going to be sharing the Word of God with us this evening, talking about winning Christ. Winning Christ from Philippians. We've got Jonathan Kearns this evening. He's going to sing a song to us as well as we celebrate the goodness of God. And we're going to just enjoy God's goodness and God's faithfulness this evening. We're not far off now. It's the 29th of December, 21. We've got a few days before we transition into 2022. So because it's the 29th of December, 21, I want to read Psalm 29 to us this evening. Ascribe to the Lord, you heavenly beings. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due to his name. Worship the Lord in the splendor of his holiness. The voice of the Lord is over the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord thunders over the mighty waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is majestic. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. The Lord breaks in pieces the cedars of Lebanon. He makes Lebanon leap like a calf sirloin, like a young wild ox. The voice of the Lord strikes with flashes of lightning. The voice of the Lord shakes the desert. The Lord shakes the desert Kadesh. The voice of the Lord twists the oaks and strips the forest bare, not stripes. And in his temple, all cry glory. The Lord sits enthroned over the flood. The Lord is enthroned as king forever. The Lord gives strength to his people. The Lord blesses his people with peace. Lord, we just decree and declare, Lord, your shalom peace. Lord, let it be in our homes. Lord, this time of year where there is suicide, there is self-harm. Lord, where is loneliness, Lord, where people are feeling discredited, where people are feeling, Lord, there's no hope and no future. Lord, I decree and I declare right now for this camera lens, Lord, into, Lord, the community of Yeadon, Lord, into our households, into our families, into our marriages, into our finances. Lord, whatever the situation, whatever the scenario, I decree and declare your shalom peace right now. Lord, we decree and declare as we, Lord, hear your word this evening, let our minds be alert, let our hearts be receptive, that we would win Christ. And everybody said, amen. Come on, let's worship God this evening. I'll be back with you very soon.
I raise a hallelujah. From prison cells to desert places, broken homes and hopeless cases, from every prayer and desperate need, time and time again you'll see what it can do. Oh, anytime that you say the name, the only name that's ever calmed the waves. Say the name, the only name that has the power to save. Say the name, the only name by which the dead are raised. Oh, say the name, just say the name of Jesus. From worried lips on doctors' faces, empty cribs and faith is shaken. When there's just no other word to speak, time and time again you'll see what it can do. Time that you say the name, the only name that's ever calmed the waves. Say the name, the only name that has a power to save. Say the name, the only name by which the dead are raised. Oh, say the name, just say the name of Jesus. Just say Jesus. It's strength and healing for the broken. It's hope and courage for the weak. That's ever calmed the waves. Say the name, the only name that has a power to save. Say the name, the only name that's ever calmed the waves. Say the name, the only name that has the power to save. Say the name, the only name by which the dead are raised. Oh, say the name, just say the name, just say the name, just say the name of Jesus. Just say Jesus. Just say Jesus.
Urge. In the year 2022, it's going to be a time of great growth for our church, for the body of Christ. And he brought to me, if I was going to title this message this morning, it would be that I may win Christ. That I may win Christ. You know, this is kind of a odd phrase in that for us to win Christ. Paul, here he is, as he brought to the body of Christ talking to them here at, in Philippians here. He told them, he said, first of all, he said, I'm a Hebrew of Hebrews. If I was at one that that really should be exalted within myself, he said, it would be me. He said, because I was a scholar. I was a Pharisee. He said, but I count it all as dung or refuge just to win Christ. If we go to chapter 3, and I want to start reading with verse 8, I think that's right. Verse 7, I'm sorry. But what things were gained to me, those I counted loss for Christ. Yea, doubtless, I count all things but loss for the excellency of the knowledge of Christ Jesus, my Lord, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things, and do count them but dung, that I may win Christ. You see, this is something in the body of Christ that we're going to have to move into in the year 2022, because there's been such a slackness in the body of Christ, an attitude, I'm going to say, in the body of Christ to where people have got to where they could care less whether they come to church or not. I don't know if it's that way at your church, and I hope and pray it's not, but all over the United States, people have got to where, I don't know if it's because of the COVID or whatever, but there's been such a falling away. And this is the fulfillment of Scripture, for the end day is the falling away, the great falling away. And we see it so much, it's prevalent in today's society and all concerning the church. And but in the year 2022, God is fixing to start touching people's heart and start moving within them in the Spirit of the living God, and them have a greater desire for church, a greater desire to win Christ, because Christ did all of this for the church. He is the head of the church. We are His body. And so He's going to be moving into this with the body of Christ. The desire that that Paul had here, that he talked about, he said, yea, doubtless, I count all things but loss for the excellency of the knowledge of Christ. He said, I'm willing to give up everything. I'm willing to go out of my way. I'm willing to do whatever I have to do to win Christ, that I may win Christ. You see, Christ in you, the hope of glory. But we have to come in Christ. You see, it's one thing for Christ to be in us, but it's another thing for Him to be supreme in us. For our life to be wrapped up in Him and everything about Him. Paul goes on and he says, and be found in him, not having my own righteousness, which is of the law, but that which is through the faith of Christ, the righteousness which is of God by faith. To understand, Paul said, the righteousness that we have in Christ. You see, Paul said, I'm willing to give up everything just to have that righteousness by that is in Christ by faith. You see, that I can do all things through Christ that strengtheneth me. Paul talks about this. And his great love for Christ, you see. He said that I may know him and the power of his resurrection. He said that I may know him. You see, the whole thing with Paul is that he may know him. I want to excel in my knowledge of Christ in the year 2022. This is the word for you today. You need to excel in 2022 in the knowledge of Christ. You want to know him. It's one thing to know about him, but it's another thing to know him. And in the year 2022, we need to come in to a walk with Christ to where everything is about him and the knowledge of him and the walk with him. And our faith is wrapped up in him where we can, it is the excellency of the knowledge of Christ, Paul said. I count everything done just for the excellency of the knowledge of Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his sufferings, being made conformable unto his death. He said that I may know him and the power of his resurrection. Understand what he said right here. You see, he didn't say the being conformed unto his death, that he may know the resurrection. He said that I may know the power of his resurrection before I even come into the sufferings and the death here. You see, because the glorious light of Christ, when we're saved and we give our hearts unto Christ, then we experience the power of his resurrection. And not only do we experience the power of his resurrection, but then we start, through the power of his resurrection, through the power of the blessed Holy Spirit, we start killing out things in our life, you see. In the year 2022, the body of Christ needs to start bringing to death the things that are not pleasing to Christ. And this is what Paul's talking about. You see, we're going to suffer, and we're going to suffer loss, whether people like it or whether they don't. You are going to suffer some loss for Christ. You will be afflicted at times, but it brings about a faith and a trust in Christ that will be tried. The word says that, and this is what Paul is talking about here. He said, "All of this that I may know him." All of this that I may win Christ. Not as though I had already attained. Either were already perfect, but I follow after. If that I may apprehend that for which I am apprehended of Christ Jesus. You see, Paul said one of the greatest things in the year 2022 is going to be to apprehend that has apprehended you. I want to apprehend Christ in the year 2022 greater than I have ever apprehended him. He has already apprehended me. Had he not, I could not even grow in him. But because he has apprehended me, he has given me the power of the Holy Spirit, I can apprehend him. I can come into a greater relationship with him. I can walk with him. I can talk with him. I can commune with him. I can walk in faith with him and see miracles and signs and wonders. This is what he's going to do in the year 2022 with us. He goes on and he says, "Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth unto those things which are before." Paul said, I can't say that I have totally apprehended him, but I am pressing every day. I'm pressing every day for the mark of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. He said, you have to understand that I may win Christ. Paul is talking here about a race. And you have to understand something about a race to comprehend what Paul is talking about here. Because in a race, when you're in a race, everything becomes irrelevant to you except winning that race. Everything becomes as dung. It doesn't matter about anything else that is around you, anything else that is going on. The only thing that you're focused on is winning that race. Paul said, This is what I'm talking about. I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. I press toward that mark. Paul said, it's one thing for Christ to be in you, but it's another thing for you to come in him. The word says in him is perfection. And we have to understand it is a daily race to get to the place to where you win Christ. You see, I used to tell the Lord when I was talking to him, I would say, "Father, I want a relationship with you so close that you would have to tell me to move over, to get out of your way where you can get to someone else." I know that sounds foolish, but it was the desire of my heart to get so close to him that he would have to say, "Mike, would you let me minister to someone else?" You know, I know that God is capable of ministering to everybody at all times, but just to show you the desire, this is the desire that Paul had. You see, he wanted to win Christ in everything. I can tell you, it will cost you. It will cost you. Look what it cost Paul. It cost him all of his prestige. It may cost you your prestige. It may cost you at your job the prestige that you really want, but you're willing to stand for Christ and you're willing to do for Him. It may cost you friends that you have walked with for years, and that it may cost you to have to separate yourself because of the move of the Holy Spirit upon you. It may cost you to have to lose some friends because you will refuse to walk and refuse to do the things that they do, that the world and what it has to offer. He says, let us therefore, as many as be perfect, be thus minded, and if anything be otherwise minded, God shall reveal even this unto you. Nevertheless, whereto we have already attained, let us walk by the same rule. Let us mind the same thing. Brethren, be followers together of me, and mark them which walk as ye have us for an example. You see, you have to understand, there's a time that we have to come to in our walk that we watch people and we know who walks with us and who doesn't. And we need to keep people that walk the walk and talk the talk, that set an example of Christ. We need to walk with them. We need to encourage them. We need to strengthen them. When Paul talked about any of the churches that he wrote to, his great salutations, he always built them up. And he would tell them, you know, I greet you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. New Life Community Church, I greet you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. May 2022 be a great year for you. May the blessings of God be upon your life. I pray that everything that God has planned for you and your family will evolve into a blessing. I thank you today, and in the precious and holy name of Jesus this morning.
Well, what a wonderful service it has absolutely been this evening, that I may win Christ. 2022, I believe, two keys for us at New Life Community Church, and I'm going to actually release an actual video to us just as a church, just to talk about 2022, our theme for the year, talk about what our vision core values are, what our fundamental foundation is, and then the infrastructure of what we're going to do through the year. But two things I do believe for 2022 for us as a church is, number one is souls, and number two is baptisms. So we're going to go for souls, we're going to believe for souls saved, at growth and expansion. Pastor Mick has spoken about this in his sermon about 2022 being the year of expansion. Sadly, the church locally and globally has seen a retraction. We've kind of almost been like holding on till Jesus comes. At New Life Community Church here, we haven't. We've carried on doing what God has called us to. We've met together, we've fellowshipped together, we've ate together. We've done loving communities, kids things in the community. But 2022 is going to be a year of expansion and growth. But I just want to encourage us the lines of giving, because God, in his scripture and in his character and in his DNA, is all about giving. He not only gave Jesus as a sacrifice for our sins, but he also gave the Holy Spirit. You see, the Trinity is made up of three, and God gave Jesus, and Jesus gave the Holy Spirit. So giving is at the core DNA and character of who Jesus is. It's part of his kingdom. And whatever we do and whatever we decide to do, we need to decide to honor God. We need to honor God through our giving. In Proverbs 3 and verse 9, it says, honor the Lord with your wealth. It says, honor the Lord with the first fruits of all of your increase. So this helps us put confidence in Christ. We give God the first fruits of our income, so which is a tithe. We believe in 10%, which is an overall. So if you get, you know, £2,000 a month, then that is £200. If you buy a house at £100,000 and sell it at £135,000, then a tithe of that is an increase. But if you bought a car at £10,000 and sell the car at £8,000, then there's no increase, that is a loss. So God, first of all, wants us to put the first fruits of all of our increase into his kingdom. Then there may be offerings above that. So you may give into, you may give into a local charity. You may give into a loving community. You may give into the building fund. You may want to bless somebody with a meal voucher or an Odeon voucher so they can go to the cinema. You may want to bless somebody, with a meal out. Anything. You may want to, next time you're at the petrol station and you fill your car up and the person is waiting behind you, you may want to pay their £30 of fuel. You know, the Bible says it's better to give than it is to receive. And I believe as we go into 2022, more than ever, God wants us to be generous with our finances. He wants to be generous with our time. He wants us to be generous with listening. He wants us to be generous in the DNA of who we are, not only individually, not only as a church, but part of the kingdom of God. In 2022, God is laying a gauntlet to us to be generous. Now, I'm not saying about being silly. I'm not saying about not being wise. But I'm saying about us being generous in every area of our capacity. Because here's the thing. We need to realize that when we honor God with our finances, we are basically acknowledging that God has ownership of everything that belongs to us. You see, I'm sat on a chair here today, but ultimately the maker of this chair was Jesus Christ. Yeah, okay, it might have come from IKEA, or it might have come from Argos, or it might come from DFS, but ultimately it's come from a tree. Ultimately, it's come from the source, which is Jesus Christ. Jesus has made everything. We are only stewards of what we choose to use on a daily basis. So as we go out of 2021, let's have this mindset going into 2022 that we're going to expand, that we're going to grow, that we're going to increase our giving capacity. At New Life Community Church here, we believe in giving. We believe in being generous over and above and beyond. Just recently, we've sown into the local Christmas Light Committee. Recently, they went out of the way to spend £200 on putting a wonderful Christmas nativity together outside the local town hall. Now, in the era that we live in the day that we live in, to have a local nativity outside a local town hall is a big boost of confidence for the Church of Jesus Christ. This was a secular group of people that did that. New Life Community Church, we sowed £500 of our finances into the local community. Now, how much more do we need to sow into our local, maybe at Easter? We could have something at Easter that assembles and replicates the death, burial and resurrection of Christ outside of our town hall. You know, the way for the church to grow and develop and have influence is to sow into government, is to sow into council, is to sow into local police, into local infrastructure. So I want to encourage you to give into the kingdom. The details will be on the bottom of the screen at the end of this service as well. The finances are detailed, the bank account details. And I thank you for your giving at New Life Community Church. But maybe you're watching locally, maybe you're watching globally. Maybe you'd like to sow a seed into what we do at New Life Community Church. Maybe New Life Community Church, I want to encourage us in 2022. I know for me, God has encouraged me, saying, Denver, you need to encourage your giving. So I'm going to be the first to step out and encourage my giving. I already believe in giving. I already believe in giving over and above and beyond. And we sow into Loving Communities Kids Week. We sow into the Building Fund. We also sow into guest speakers when they come. We also partner with various other missions around the world, and we give into that as well. But I do believe God is saying to me in 2022, it's going to be a year of increase, an increase of souls. There's going to be baptisms. It's going to be a year of increase of influence. But also, Denver, you need to increase your financial giving. Maybe you're stalemate. Maybe you've given the same amount for the past 5 years, maybe the past 6 years. And please, you know, those of you that know me at New Life Community Church, you know that I'm not a prosperity preacher. But I do believe in giving and being generous. You know, but how many of you know that I can choose to live in truth decay? And I could say, well, the truth is that the church takes all my money. The truth is I've not seen God expand or develop. Well, maybe you have fear of finances. Maybe you've got fear of giving. But I want to encourage you today to give, to be blessed beyond, pressed down, shaken together, that God will give into your bosom. Now, please, please, please do not hear what I'm not saying. I'm not a prosperity preacher. I'm not saying you've not got to pay your gas bill or your electric bill. You've got to give into the church. I believe you've got to give within your means. You've got to live within your means. But I do also believe that God is saying to us that he wants us to curse the devourer. And he wants us to live in 2022 in expansion. So I want to leave you with that. The details are on the bottom of the screen. Lord, we just thank you today that, Lord, you will bless all of our giving. Lord, I pray, Lord, that you will bless our tithing. Lord, that we'll be blessed when we go out. That we'll be blessed when we come in. Lord, we'll be blessed when we stand up. Blessed when we sit down. Lord, we claim those promises of God that are yes and amen in Christ Jesus. Lord, I just pray, Lord, and I break off the devourer of our finances. That our finances will be blessed, that our children will be blessed, that our houses will be blessed, that our cars will be blessed, that our businesses will be blessed. We decree and we declare financial breakthrough. I decree and declare finances from unexpected sources in the mail, checks we never had realized we had coming, and cash advancements in the precious name of Jesus. Be blessed in all of your giving. Just to say, we do have a New Year's Eve service, 8 p.m. It'll be a short one, but we're going to do communion. We're going to do a short word as well of reaching into 2022 with love. 31st of December, 8 p.m., we'll be gathering together online, celebrating and transitioning into 2022. Then we're gathering together this Sunday, the 2nd of January, 10:30 a.m., in-person gathering. We'll be worshipping, we'll be taking our first communion, we'll be taking our offering, but also we'll be fellowshipping together around food. There will be jacket potatoes, cheese, beans, and chili. So this Sunday, in-person gathering, invite a friend, invite a relative, invite a neighbor. In order for us to see souls saved, let's invite somebody that does not believe in Jesus Christ, and let's invite them back to the house of God. Love you, believe in you. We'll see you New Year's Eve, 8 p.m. online. And if we don't see you online, we'll see you in person this Sunday, 2nd of January, 10:30 a.m. Love you, believe in you, and standing with you. See you soon.